your coat of many colors with pride. Jacob had 12 sons. The 11th boy was called Joseph. The father loved him so much. In Genesis 37, 1 to 5. So the father made a coat of many colors for the son. That coat was a coat that singled him out. It gave him a certain identity. It made him so unique. He carried a certain glow because of the coat. And the Bible said because of that coat, his brothers hated him and would not speak well with him. And when he's speaking, they will shut him down. They didn't like him just because of that coat. Now, if we had some of you, maybe if you're you, Frank, or if you're you, Joe, maybe you would say, okay, since they don't like me, when I'm going to wear there, I will never wear that coat. I will put the coat down. But not Joseph. Joseph did not put the coat down. He wore it with pride. Everywhere he went, even including farm. The father sent him to farm to go and give food to his brothers. He wore the coat. When he got there, they said, ah, here cometh the dreamer. When they finally sold him, it was that coat they removed and put blood in and brought to the father. He was wearing the coat even to farm. When you are in Caesar's house, please put on your coat of many colors. In other words, don't be shy about your Christianity. Show everybody that you are a Christian. You are the tongue talking type. You are Pentecostal. You go to church. Today I can't come to work. I'm going to church. Tell them. They say, oh, shall we meet on Sunday 11? You said, no. Sunday 11? No. Sundays are for church. I am a church person. I go to church. Say, what time will you close? He said, I can't tell you. But if you have more time when I close, I'll call you. But I will not close until the church is closed. I am a church man. I worship God. I am a Christian. Let your Christian identity be around everywhere you go. Don't hide it. Don't hide it thinking you are being nice, you are being polished. All the people you are dealing with, some of them are worse than anything. Some of them can sleep with animals. Nasty things they can do. And you are trying to think to dignify them. If there is anybody you must dignify, it's your God. Not human beings. Who are diabolical, their minds are weird. They look neat in suit. But the things they can do underground, you have no idea. And you are there, you thinking that if I say I'm a Christian, I'll feel bad. Don't feel bad. Raise your head up, chest out. Your forehead is harder. Let people know when they are talking about what they talk, you say, I'm a Christian. I don't enjoy this conversation. Don't say, I don't like this. I'm busy. No. Tell them to their face. I'm a Christian. I don't enjoy this conversation. I'm a Christian. I read them. Are you doing the serious one? Yes, more than serious. More than serious. It's something that happened. And there's something. I would have been a pastor by now. I'm a serious Christian. I'm a serious Christian. Come to my church and see. They don't joke with me. Let people carry your cross everywhere. Be like Apostle Paul. Romans 1:16. He said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ because it is the power to salvation. Unto salvation for everyone that believeth. To the Jew first and also to the Greek. Don't be ashamed of God. Don't be ashamed of your Christianity. Tap somebody and say, wear your coat of many colors with pride, with dignity. Let everybody know you are a Christian sister. You don't fornicate. You don't follow after boys. You don't go to bad places. Let them know the reason why you cannot be at the club is because you are a Christian. You won't come there. You are a Christian.
This message is brought to you by OKTV, Adonai Car and Truck Rentals, Travels and Vacation, African Chop Bar, Gibbo's Variety Store, and Voice of Greatness.